By the end of this video, you should have a better idea of velocity fields and how we could sketch those. And we're going to start by looking at a conceptual question regarding velocity fields. Specifically, we are given a velocity equal to 2y only in the x component of direction, and we're given units of meters per second. And we're asked to determine which plot best describes the field. So right away, you should see that because we're only working in the x direction, we could cross out option B. So we have to determine whether or not it's A, C, or neither. So what we're told here is that as y changes, our velocity component is also going to change. So it's not going to stay constant with y. So we could get rid of the first choice. So then we look at the last choice, and we see that as we increase in the y direction, our x component of velocity is increasing. And we could see that as we increase y, our x direction is doubling. So option C is a plot that best describes the velocity field given above. Let's take a look at another one. So in this question, we're given a velocity field equaling 2y plus 2. And you can see that the 2y component is in the x component of direction, and the 2 is in the y component of direction. So we're asked to determine which plot below best describes this field. So we could rewrite this as the x component of velocity is equal to 2y, and the y component of velocity is equal to 2. Might as well finish this off and say that the z component is 0. So based on these two components, we could see that as we increase y, we're going to change the magnitude in the x direction. But as we increase in either x or y directions, the y component of the velocity is going to remain constant. So because we have a change in the x direction and no change in the y direction, we can cross out option A since both the x and y components of the velocity look pretty constant. Looking at option B, we see as we increase along the x-axis, initially the velocity starts to increase in both the x and y components. And then eventually it looks like the x component decreases and the y component increases. Because the y component is increasing in the x direction, we can cross out option B. Now we look at option C and we see that the y component velocity is about the same regardless of position. So that would verify that part of our velocity. And as we look at x, as we increase along the y-axis, our x component is increasing. So this plot, option C, best describes this velocity field. In this problem, we see that the x component of velocity is equal to xy, and the y component of velocity is equal to 2. So the first thing we should do is write this out in vector form. We have xy times the I component plus 2 times the y component of velocity. So in this problem, we want to determine the equation for the streamlines and plot on a positive y-axis only. So instead of just writing the velocities and representing those with arrows, we're actually going to draw streamlines. And remember, a streamline is tangent everywhere to this velocity field. So we want to determine what our streamline looks like, and since it's tangent everywhere to the velocity field, we can determine what that tangent function looks like. So this is just going to be the v component over the u component. So this is 2 over xy. Now we separate this and integrate. We get y dy is equal to 2 over x dx. And after integration, we get the following. So our streamlines will have the function of 1/2 y squared minus 2 natural log of x, and this will be equal to some constant. So in the problem statement, we're asked to plot the streamlines on a positive y-axis only. So I've drawn that here, and so to do this, we basically pick any constant that we want and then plot that streamline. So let's pick the first constant of equaling 0, and we see that we're going to have an equation of the form y equals 4 natural log of x to the square root. If we picked a constant of 1, we would have something very similar, but we would have it plus 2 inside of the parentheses. So this is for 1, this is for a constant of 0. If we did 2, we would have 4 natural log of x plus 4, and so forth. You could use a graphing calculator or any kind of program at this point, and you would graph these lines, and they would roughly look like this, where this would be for a constant of 0, this would be for a constant of 1, constant of 2, and so forth. And what you'll notice is that both the x component of the velocity and the y component of the velocity are positive with positive x and y. So I'm drawing these arrows to show what that velocity field would look like if we picked a point and determined the velocities at the point. So hopefully this gives you a good idea on velocity fields and how we would determine the streamlines based on those velocity coordinates.